sun and clouds. Also a thunderstorm in spots well north and west of the city, high 86. Right now 84 with some sunshine overhead, humidity 52%, and the wind southwest at 10. 84 going down to 69 in Midtown. I'm Kerry Schwindenhammer on New York's weather station, 1010 winds on 92.3 FM.
And word from Miami today, ex-President Trump has been given his trial date for the documents trial, and it clashes with the RNC convention where they picked the presidential nominee for the party. We'll have details on it when we come back. Wentz News Time, 314.
This is Juliana Tarian, president and CEO of Rally Motor Company. Our family of dealerships, including Acura, BMW, Lexus, and Mercedes-Benz, opened its doors 65 years ago. When you come to Rally, you want exceptional care, an easy process, and transparency. That's exactly what you get. We're honored to have you be a part of the Rally family, and I look forward to meeting you in one of our locations.
That's RALLY.com. Experience luxury simplified at the Rally Motor Company.
Earn $1,000 when you refer an Amazon Hub partner. Amazon is looking to partner with Manhattan business owners for Amazon Hub delivery. The Amazon Hub delivery program provides another revenue stream for local businesses when they help deliver Amazon packages in their neighborhood. There's no upfront cost or long-term contracts. Refer a business now at Amazon.com/hub delivery, and for a limited time, earn $1,000 for each referral that successfully signs up. Amazon.com/hub delivery.
Wednesday's time, 3:15. Rescuers have found the body of a 21-year-old college student who fell to his death while climbing a mountain in Oregon with his girlfriend. But the steep, loose, rocky terrain is preventing them from recovering. He used a drone to find Joe Tranby's body and then spotted it from a helicopter. Now, expert climbers are being consulted now to see if they can, you know, get up and safely recover the body. Tranby fell 300 to 5,000 feet on Monday. His girlfriend was able to use her cell phone to call for help. A GoFundMe page now has been set up to establish a scholarship in his memory and raise money for the recovery effort. So far, they've raised about $13,000. Federal judge down in Florida has scheduled a trial date now for the classified document trial of ex-President Donald Trump.
In a compromise ruling, the judge scheduled former President Trump's trial for May 20th, later than prosecutors wanted, but sooner than the indefinite delay until after the election that Trump had sought. Judge Aileen Cannon said the special counsel's proposed December date was too soon, given the complexity of the case and the volume of evidence, including more than 1,500 classified documents, more than a million non-classified pages, and months of security camera footage. Trump has pleaded not guilty to more than 36 counts. The May date means he will first stand trial in the New York hush money case. Aaron Katursky, ABC News, New York.
People on Twitter are commenting that it was the judge who first said the trial should start in August, and that the prosecutor, Jack Smith, that is, pushed it back to December. So who knows? Meantime, Jack Smith is reportedly wanting to talk to former police commissioner Bernard Kerik. Kerik worked with former Mayor Giuliani in their unsuccessful effort to find widespread voter fraud in the 2020 election. Fans of the sequel to this 1988 hit film turning into scavengers now.
It's him, Beetlejuice.
Go ahead, Barbara Sam.
Yeah. Beetlejuice.
Before the actor strike, Beetlejuice 2 was shooting in Vermont. Now that filming has been paused, they say souvenir hunters are just going crazy, taking over the set in East Corn at the large lamppost topped with a distinctive pumpkin figure, covered in a tarp and lifted onto a pickup truck, which sped off. Another 150-pound abstract art piece was grabbed from a cemetery. A new sophisticated scheme to get consumers to wire money out of their accounts.
Morgan Lott says the caller identified himself as a Chase employee, and he would help her cancel the fraudulent transfer.
He told me you need to enter this account number that the account it was going to. Section by section, he was telling me how to do it.
Lott says she saw all the money in her accounts disappear, but that the scammer promised this was all a part of the wire reversal process.
The next morning, I kind of got like a gut feeling something wasn't right, and I called Chase, and they're like, no, you were scammed.
In the end, she says she lost more than $11,000.
Wow, if it looks too good, folks, to be true, it probably is not true. Correspondent Becky Worley reporting. Wentz News Time, 318.
Are you forming a corporation, LLC, or trust?
Searching for anonymity?
Tax savings and asset protection for your family or business?
If so, get a free information packet by texting the word FREE to 212-962-1000.
Form your New York corporation now for less than $175.
It's complete and includes state filing fee, corporate seal, records book, certificate of incorporation, minutes, corporate bylaws, corporate stock certificate, banking resolution, preliminary name search, and attorney
at first thought it was the work of one attacker, but they've since found out otherwise. Remembering Tony Bennett, the New York native passed away today. Tintin went visiting with people who knew him as a regular at a local cafe here in town. Not to mention reaction from some of the biggest names in show business. President Biden got a handshake from some of the biggest names in artificial intelligence today. A commitment to make sure any products they release are safe and secure. He called a big roundtable today to talk about the risks. Entertainment, the battle of the box office, and even previews of a certain flick has taken off like a rocket. We'll have details in a moment. Down on Wall Street, the markets aren't taking off with any big numbers, but at least they are with the plus column. We'll have the latest numbers as we close in with the final bell for the week at 26 past. And AccuWeather is cloudy and humid with thunderstorms this afternoon at a high of 79 degrees. What's news time 321 now, and from your Mercedes-Benz of Edison.com traffic center, here's Greg Rice.
Oh, there's some traffic you sit in. Some traffic you sit in where you start punching the steering wheel and screaming. That's what we've got on the West Side Highway. You are just not moving either way over the West 110th Street. It's banned south that ramp, but it's everybody's problem. Excruciatingly slow on the south that west side from the 150s north end jammed up. We're just north of the Intrepid Riverside Drive or Broadway. You're going to need traffic lights, but it's going to be less stressful. East side of town, slow go on the rip at FDR or the Queensboro Bridge south that west.
Detectives James Essex says a tremendous amount of resources went into this case. track video from the 89th Street and Riverside Park incident to a location where they observed the male in the video with a similar bicycle.
Police say he also implicated himself in a groping incident in June. Samantha Liebman, Tintin Wins on 92.3 FM at police headquarters.
Wins News Time 3:26 and Bloomberg Money Watch on 1010 Wins, sponsored by your Tri-State BMW Centers.
They were our North Star. and she says Tony insisted on keeping a low profile.
If you want to know about Tony, that's it. He insisted that the school be named after his great friend, Frank Sinatra.
According to Walsh, Tony also had mentors. The foundation has established that model so young people can learn from others with guidance and experience. Julia Papa, 1010 Winds on 92.3 FM. Time now for traffic and transit with Greg Rice.
Now, the ride at this hour on the Whitestone Expressway is just awful in either direction between Northern Boulevard and the Whitestone Bridge. Clearview throgs that combination. Going to be a much better option for Brooklyn. Eastbound side of the Bells getting over to Erskine Street. You got a stalled car in the right lane. That's doing a number all the way back to the Verrazano. Westbound Bells, you're crowded in Queens in front of Kennedy. And again, from Flatbush Avenue all the way to the Verrazano at Narrows Bridge. Jersey, you're starting to lose the battle on the Garden State Parkway northbound. Getting up towards the area of exit 148. We are dealing with an accident and an absolute mess all the way back through the Union Toll. Southbound Parkway near exit 127 in Woodbridge. That's an accident. And you got the left lane knocked out of service. Southbound New Jersey Turnpike car and truck lanes are slow from Newark Airport all the way on down past the Goffles Bridge. Here's what you need to know about the bridges and tunnels. Citybound George 45 up 30 down. Nothing easy out on the west side of SI the way to West 110th Street with a crash. Lincoln 30 minutes in. 30 to 40 out from 11, better elsewhere. Holland Tunnel, 40 to 60 on the outbound ride. Outbound covered roadway, inbound skyway, just awful. You're on the Newark Bay instead. Traffic is sponsored by Plaza Jewish Community Chapel. I'm Greg Rice, 1010 Winds on 92.3 FM.
We at Plaza Jewish Community Chapel would like to remind you that candle lighting is at 8:04 this evening. Good Shabbos and Shabbat Shalom.
Now the AccuWeather 4-day forecast. Here is meteorologist Carrie Schwindenhammer.
Our severe thunderstorm watch continues until 8 o'clock this evening for Putnam and Westchester counties, as well as all of Connecticut. And I do think the best chance for severe weather is certainly going to be north of the city. In fact, most of the activity has been across northwestern New Jersey, heading on into Orange and Rockland counties, also across Connecticut. But there's been some showers and a bit of thunder in Long Island as well. Nothing near the city right now as we speak. We'll be keeping an eye on things, though, as we head through the evening. Of course, there could be some gusty winds and downpours with any thunderstorm. Some clouds today overnight, the low 69, the humidity will drop for tomorrow. Partly sunny, the high 85, mainly clear tomorrow night. We'll drop to the 50s in some of the coolest spots north and west of the city. Around 70 in the city itself, the low humidity continues Sunday with sunshine and high 86. By Monday, humidity starts to tick back up again, not as much as Tuesday, but there could be a thunderstorm well north and west of the city, high 86. 84 with some sun overhead, humidity 52%, the wind southwest of 10. 84 going down to 69 in Midtown. I'm AccuWeather's Carrie Schwindenhammer from New York's weather station. 1010 Winds on 92.3 FM.
Jack Bucky lets you order official state lottery games on your phone instead of waiting online. The Mega Millions is now over $720 million. So use code RADIO for a free ticket with your first play. 18 year old gambling problem. Give your call 1-877-HOPE-NY. Text HOPE-NY. New Jersey call 1-800-GAMBLER. See jackbucky.com/DOS for terms.
Wednesday's time, 3:34. Will it be Barbie this weekend?
Hi, Barbie. Hi, Barbie. Muslim worshippers. Emma said he was working against the epidemic.
your journey. Own every mile.
Now lease an Elantra for $229 a month, or get 2.49% APR for 48 months, or $500 bonus cash. See your local Hyundai dealer today. Call 661-615-2112 for offer details.
Next news time, 3:38 now. 1010 Winds Entertainment. It's Barbie with the edge so far.
I don't have anything big planned, just a giant blowout party with all the Barbies and planned choreography and a bespoke song. We should stop by.
On a giant weekend, Barbie has already raked in over $22 million in previews as it heads into the weekend box office. Oppenheimer is a strong second, on pace to open with nearly $50 million in all. New music today from Zayn Malik. The former One Direction member is out with Love Like This, his first single in 2 years. Britney Spears wants you to mind your business. The new single from Spears and Will.i.am dropped today. The two last collaborated on 2021's Scream and Shout.
Services. To learn
more about Glenn Gareth's personalized brand of care and unique programming, visit carerightcenters.com. We start where others stop.
New Jersey trying to put the brakes on congestion pricing. Governor Murphy says he's heading to court against his neighbor across the river. The MTA is dismissing the suit as baseless.
The governor's first shot across the Hudson seeks to scuttle congestion pricing on environmental grounds.
We're particularly disappointed